Here Allah is saying, Ya Ayyuhannas, O people, Ya Ayyuhannas, a reminder has come to you from your Rabb. Sometimes if you say Allah, someone might say, I don't believe in Allah. Well, tell them your maker, that's who Allah is, your maker, the one who is in control of every aspect of your existence. So a maw'idha has come to you from your Rabb, this reminder and cure. Now cure, before we get into cure from what do you want cure from? That's the question. So do you suffer any illness, any sickness? I think a lot of us do not have the type of contentment and peace and happiness internally that we would like to have. So this is why Allah says, Shifa'un. What we have sent to you, what has come to you, and this is referring to the Quran, and this is referring to the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what has come to you is a reminder from your Rabb, from your maker, your nourisher, the one who owns this, your sustenance, and cure for that which is in the chest. So what lies in the chest, subhanallah, amazing. The blood vessels lie within the chest, and if I am sick or ill, I need to test my blood and see, determine what type of a sickness I have. And the headquarters of that blood is the heart. It pumps out the blood everywhere. So Allah is saying, we have sent down to you, we have given you already that which has in it the cure for what is in your heart. Amazing. Subhanallah. This is the gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa hudan. And in it there is guidance. We look for guidance. We want to be guided. People say, I need guidance. But then when we come up with the rulings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people say, oh, that's too tough, or I don't agree with this. How can you not agree with something that Allah has stipulated? How can you not agree? Do you know that Allah has made you and me? It's like someone saying, I don't agree to put petrol into the vehicle at this place here. I want to put petrol into the battery. Or I want to put perhaps maybe air into the tank. Or maybe I want to put the wheel right at the top. You cannot do that because your machine will not operate. Your vehicle will not move. So Allah has created us. We are far more sophisticated than anything else. And we need to know and realize that Allah says, we have sent you guidance, a guide to guide you, to show you the path of happiness, the path of success, every single path you can think of goodness, and even to show you how important it is to remain away or to stay away from the evil path. The path that leads towards bad and evil is also made clear so that we can stay away from it. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa rahmatun, and mercy. So guidance and mercy, guidance and mercy, the point of mercy. But who will achieve mercy? Everyone wants mercy. We are at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will only achieve mercy if we understand that Allah alone is to be worshipped, and we understand why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent to us. He was sent as a mercy, subhanallah. So we need to know and realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, lil mu'minin, it is only for those who believe. Those who believe truly are the ones who will benefit properly from the revelation of the Quran. We need to know this, and we need to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is felt by those who believe in His mercy. They know it. Like we were saying, sometimes those who are not mu'mineen, who are not believers, they do not see the light because they do not want to see the light. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from those. You want solutions to your problems? Yes, they are there. The one who made you has told you or has shown you the path, told you what the solutions are. It's up to you to follow it. It's up to you to try it out, see. And we have no option but not only to try it out, but implement it, put it into your life, see, it will open your doors. May the Almighty grant us every form of goodness, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.